End of chapter 39. The Gilded Age, A Tale of Today, by Mark Twain and C.D. Warner. Chapter 40.
Open your ears, for which of you will stop the vent of hearing when loud rumor speaks? I, from the Orient to the drooping West, making the wind my post-horse, still unfold the axe commenced on this ball of earth. Upon my tongues continual slanders ride, the which in every language I pronounce, stuffing the ears of men with false reports.
King Henry IV. As may be readily believed, Colonel Beriah Sellers was by this time one of the best-known men in Washington. For the first time in his life, his talents had a fair field. He was now at the center of the manufacture of gigantic schemes, of speculations of all sorts, of political and social gossip. The atmosphere was full of little and big rumors and of vast, undefined expectations. Everybody was in haste, too, to push on his private plan, and feverish in his haste, as if in constant apprehension that tomorrow would be Judgment Day. Work, while Congress is in session, said the uneasy spirit, for in the recess there is no work and no device. The colonel enjoyed this bustle and confusion amazingly. He thrived in the air of indefinite expectation. All his own schemes took larger shape and more misty and majestic proportions, and in this congenial air the colonel seemed even to himself to expand into something large and mysterious. If he respected himself before, he almost worshipped Beriah Sellers now as a superior being. If he could have chosen an official position out of the highest, he would have been embarrassed in the selection. The presidency of the Republic seemed too limited and cramped in the constitutional restrictions. If he could have been Grand Lama of the United States, that might have come to the nearest to his idea of a position. And next to that, he would have luxuriated in the irresponsible omniscience of the special correspondent.